Good afternoon. My name is Jeff Thompson. I'm a senior partner at the law firm of the Franchise Business Law Group. Been practicing franchise law for over 35 years. Today I'm going to talk to you, first of all, about territories. Determining a territory as you start a franchise is an important consideration. You have to decide up front if you're going to have a territory, how big that territory is going to be, and what is it you're looking for in setting up the territory. Oftentimes, when we talk to clients in the beginning, they think about a territory being exclusive or non-exclusive. Today, those terms are not particularly helpful because of the changes that have happened in the industry, particularly the internet and other types of marketing and distribution for the franchisor. The franchisor usually reserves the right to provide some services or products into the territory, and therefore it becomes non-exclusive territory. But we use the term protected territory to refer to the territory of the franchisee, and that term is defined to mean that particular business, that brick and mortar business, mobile business, or whatever it is, will not be set up by the franchisor within the territory. It will be only that business that will operate within the territory. The next question that you have as you're looking at it is the size of the territory, and that depends on some of the factors I just discussed, but it also has to be large enough that the franchisee can be successful. You're examining the demographics of the territory, the population in the territory, the businesses in the territory, and are trying to set up a large enough territory that they can attract enough customers to their store or unit to be successful. But on the other hand, you don't want it to be so large that you inadvertently lock out the opportunity of opening up another franchise within that vicinity. And oftentimes in the beginning, franchisors are anxious to get started, they want to get established, and there's a tendency to make the territories too large, and then they have to be renegotiated later. So it's an important consideration as you look at that. You also need to decide, is my franchise primarily for an urban population or a rural population or both? And that determination is an important one, and it affects the size of the territory, and especially in denser population areas, the territory is usually a little bit smaller. You also need to consider, am I going to have a brick and mortar store? Is it going to be a mobile store? If it's going to be brick and mortar, am I going to allow a mobile unit to be attached and used in relationship to that store? And then, of course, in today's industry, there is home delivery. There are home delivery services, and many franchisors have their own home delivery service. That will affect the size of your territory and how it works. So that's also an important consideration. The attorneys of the Franchise and Business Law Group can assist you in setting your territory, helping to guide you in the size of your territory and the demographics of that territory.